And we're back with the next episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. On this platform, as you can see, you have Cinderella, and in a sense, this platform will represent for Sora an tutorial of basically a change that he's going to go through from his own dream or inner heart. Basically, in a sense, he wants to change, and because he wants to change, I'm going to use this right now because the game's going to use it anyway. His inner light sort of wills it to be so. You know, he gains the ability to fight. You know, so that's really what this platform is about. It's kind of like the short intro to you know, to fighting and moving while fighting, and what happens when you are in a fight. So it's pretty straightforward like that. Now, these are the first enemies that you were introduced to in the game. I'm pretty sure they are just called shadows. Like, there's nothing special about them. They have two different types of attacks, and then they have two different forms of movement. Their first attack is a jumping leap, and their second is just a normal type forward slash, as you saw right there. Their normal movement is running around, and their other movement is sinking into the ground, where they are invulnerable for a short period of time before they eventually rise up again. They have a 10% chance of dropping potions early on in the game, and they drop money later in the game, and for right now, the green balls that you see Sora picking up are called health orbs. So, you know, remember that because, well, you'll see them everywhere pretty much whenever you defeat anything. And they'll replenish your health, which is always pretty important. So yeah. Now, this platform, I'm fairly certain that's supposed to be Aurora, you know, like Sleeping Beauty, but I'm not going to speculate on that. But as for this actual platform, here you're going to learn about commands, like examine, and barrels, and crates as well. Oh, and treasure chests. Let's not forget that. Those are very important. Speaking of treasure chests, I will be making sure to get every single treasure chest in the game and showing you how to get the secret ending, whether you're playing on expert or normal, because there are different requirements for such secret ending due to the different difficulties. Like, if you're playing normal, you have to do some more. If you're playing expert, I believe all you have to do is just beat the game, and that's really it, if I'm not mistaken. I don't remember exactly for the expert one, but I know it's a lot easier. So yeah, you know. Now, as you can see, you have commands here. In order to siphon through your commands, you can either A, use the diagonal controls on the leftmost side of the PlayStation 2 controller, or you can use the right control stick, which is a lot quicker in my opinion. So you can actually also make your command, you know, like, let's say I had attack as my command, and I push down on the right stick on the PlayStation 2 controller, it'll make me attack. I don't have to press X if I wanted to, but it's kind of fickle with a PlayStation 2 controller, so I prefer to just press X. So, yes. Now, this is the part of the game where you choose at which pace you level, and it's also the first part where you're introduced to characters you can actually talk to. Just in case you're wondering, no, you cannot run away from this little part. You have to talk to these guys. Just in case you're not familiar with who they are, this is Selphie from Final Fantasy VIII, and the other two are from Final Fantasy X, Tidus, or Tidus, whatever you want to call him, and Waka. Now, for shortened, you know, to like basically put this in a concise manner, if you choose all three, the top option, or if you choose the top option for all three of them, you will level quickly until level 50, and then the rest of the game you will level slowly. If you choose the middle, you'll level at the same rate throughout the entire game, and if you choose all of the bottom ones for all three, you will level slowly at the beginning of the game, and once you reach level 50, you will level quickly. For the sake of this LP, I'm going to be choosing the leveling slowly at the beginning and quickly at the end, because it's much easier to level in the beginning, in my opinion, than it is to level at the end. it's not to say that, you know, it's more, how do I put this? It's not to say it's more difficult at any one point or another, but, in order to level at the end, the way I'm going to show you to get to the top level, in, like, a snap like that, it's through boss battles in the, well, in a certain area where you can fight, you know, certain special bosses, and I'd rather not use as much of my time as I have to getting to level 99 doing that, because it is time consuming, and there are spots you can grind at lower levels early on in the game that make low level leveling a lot easier in my opinion, and I'll be showing you that so you don't have to worry. So anyway, this platform actually is Aurora, now Sleeping Beauty. And to me, the significance of this platform is that Sora here is sort of awakening to something new within him that, you know, he wasn't used to. This light that, you know, he's never really been aware of, that's always been with him since he was a child. At least, you know, if you've ever played the other games, this is the interpretation that I've always received to this. I know I'm kind of going in-depth into this, so, I mean, you know, it might take away from the actual gameplay or something like that to you guys, but personally, I'm always fascinated by, you know, the symbolic representation of things, even in video games, movies, anything like that. So I'm trying to break this down for you guys as I go through the game, so you can understand how I feel when I play this game and I see things like that. Because I mean, you know, really, I think they put a lot more into this psychologically than most people, you know, understand on the surface. You know, there's a lot more to this game than meets the eye. And I'm going to... Well, I want to show you that. So, yeah. Now, the next platform is a very important one. It's the last platform that's in the tutorial. And it's also the boss fight of this segment. I'm going to be showing you how to complete this boss fight. Not only in the simplest way, but also in the way where you can earn the most amount of experience points from this boss. Now also, you might notice the platform here is Beauty and the Beast. Now this is actually my favorite platform to analyze and look at, because here, this is where literally Sora is facing his inner darkness, his beast, so to speak, and in essence, Sora is Light himself, aka the Beauty, as everyone knows in the story, and the Beast is his darkness. So, in a sense, he is conquering the Beast, and that is what he's supposed to be doing in this battle. So, you know, that's my interpretation of the platform and what it's supposed to represent. So now, with further ado, or rather with no further ado, whichever one it may be, this is Darkseid. Darkseid has about 240 health, or HP, however you want to do it. I don't know exactly how you're supposed to know those measurements. I saw it in a guide, which I will be posting along in the link to my video descriptions. Now, the first thing you want to do is he'll start out by summoning shadows. You want to run off to the side of Darkseid, and you want to kill these shadows, but make sure you do not attack Darkseid straight away. Reason being is, he will do this. He will get on his knees, and he will lob spears of darkness at you, which you will repel to him and directly at his face. For doing this, you get 3 experience for each orb that you reflect back at him. Excuse me. So as you can tell, this is obviously the best way to defeat him while gaining the most experience. So basically, let's see, I did 1, 2, 3, and then I think 3 at once. So that was 6, and 6 times 3, so that's 18 experience that I got there. If I'm not mistaken, it might be, it might be like 15 or something, I don't remember, but either way, or not 15, maybe more than that, I don't know, I suck at math, who cares, whatever. So, this is the best way to fight Darkseid. As you saw, I got a level already, and I'm still in the tutorial, you know? So, I plan to leave this tutorial and be at least level 3, you know, if maybe, I might be level 2, but I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get another level here. And this is one of the reasons why I decided to... Yeah, see, look, level 3. Anyway, and this is one of the reasons why I decided to level slowly at the beginning, because they practically hand experience to you just straight from the tutorial.